super easy. It doesn't have 7 to 8 layers and it takes probably less than an hour to make. So let's just start making it. I have my eggs, 4 of them, room temperature, and 3/4 cup granulated sugar. And you are going to whisk this on high speed 2 to 4 minutes, probably until it's fluffy and pale color. This is how you want your egg and sugar mixture to look. And at this point, I like to continue mixing with paddle attachment, just not to deflate this egg mixture. So this goes here. And then I'm gonna put this one. And we're gonna mix it on low speed now. Just a little bit vanilla extract. Spoonful, and we can add our honey, the main ingredient. You will mix this on low speed now, probably 2 minutes or so, or even less than 2 minutes, and we can start adding our dry ingredients. I already mixed up my flour, baking powder, baking soda, and some pinch of salt, and I will put detailed recipe in my website. And we are adding this in 3 to 4 portions, just slowly. That's it, this is ready. And it took me less than 10 minutes to make the butter. So that's how easy it is, even from the beginning. And the same cake you can make with gluten-free flour. Just different amount, and I will put the amount in my website as well with the recipe. That's it. And I prepared 12 inch round cake pans. You want to make sure to line the baking pan because this is very sticky cake, the dough I mean. And I even would suggest to lightly spray that paper, just lightly, and you are going to eyeball it like approximately into 3 portions, just lightly spray to make sure it doesn't stick. Just make sure as even as possible. And using the knife, regular knife, lightly and gently spread this on the paper. Again, as even as possible. When it bakes, it will even up already, so don't worry. That's it. So we have 3 of these layers, and we're going to bake this in 350 degrees for approximately 13 to 15 minutes. But keep an eye because this bake pretty quickly, and depending on oven type, like baking time may be different. So just watch your cakes. The last one is out. Okay, you wanna make sure to remove this paper right after you take it out from baking, from the oven, because as I already said, it's very sticky. So what you're gonna do, just quickly, and you can either leave it on your cooling rack or quickly turn it back to its parchment paper, but since it's free here, I can just put it right there. Okay, and while it's cooling down, I'm going to show you how to make the frosting, which is 200 grams of butter, an entire can of sweetened condensed milk, and I just had this one on hand, which is already made into caramel, but you can use regular. You don't have to use the caramel kind. I just had this one hand. Okay, and you are going first to whip your butter until it's pale and fluffy, and then we'll start adding condensed milk. And just quickly, I'm adding some vanilla before I start mixing. On high. How it's supposed to look, all white and fluffy. And we just start adding our condensed milk, and we will also be needing to add some cocoa powder, which is already sifted. Make sure to sift the cocoa powder. You don't want to have lumps in it in your frosting. Okay, so just on low speed and a little bit at a time. I'm done adding condensed milk, and again, you don't have to use the caramel kind, just use regular condensed milk. Okay, this is done. You will add cocoa powder, and your frosting should be done as well. A little bit at a time also. Don't dump everything in it all at once. And you want to make sure you eyeball the quantity for each layer equally for the frosting. That's why it's easier if you pour the frosting into a shallow bowl and just with your spatula divide it into three portions, just to make sure you have enough amount, like equal amount for each layer. And I will show you something else before I start frosting this. Okay, well, this is gonna wait for a few seconds. I normally don't do this, but if you want to have like perfectly round shape layers, I would suggest, I cut in 9-inch parchment paper. You are going to just use a pizza knife and evenly slice it. Not slice it, just run your knife and cut the uneven corners. And these corners dry up very quickly, and don't throw these away. First of all, you can eat them. Second of all, you can decorate your cake. That's another option to decorate. Okay. Normally, I would first decorate frost the cake, decorate, put it in a fridge, and then later transfer to my cake stand. So, what I'm gonna do first of all, let's just make sure we eyeball the frosting equally. So we have three parts. We're just gonna put it like this. And I normally save a bigger part for last layer, because we also need a little more for the sides. So this looks okay, so I'm gonna use these two, and this one I'm gonna leave for last and for corners, for sides. Very quick and very easy. And you want to save the most even layer for the last one, just to have an even top. Or you can just put it on upside down. Now, just make sure it doesn't have these air pockets. Now I'm gonna check. This looks better. So I'll save this one for the last one. gonna go like this. As even as possible. Alright, this is gonna go on top. And last one, just give it a quick press, just to give up all the frosting. For the sides, you may need to use a regular knife, so it's easier. Like this. I'll do the top first of all. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to finish up this frosting process and show you how to decorate the cake. So this is ready, and again, you can either crumble these corners and sprinkle over your cake, or you can just simply use some chocolate shavings to decorate. I melted some chocolate, semi-sweet chocolate chunks with heavy cream and butter. I put the measurements in the recipe and you can just look it up. And make sure it's completely cooled down. And you're going to cut the tip very small, like the chip it from the tip. Tip it! Just to make sure you have enough for squeezing. When it's too hot, you can later correct this. Okay, so wish me luck. Here it goes. Just do some circles. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Later we're gonna do something else with these circles. Alright. And with that same stick that you used to find the center, you're just going to do these lines on the cake. This is pretty simple. I'm done decorating and I'm going to place this in my fridge for 30 minutes or so, and later I will just show you how to slice it and I'll show you how to eat it. Alright, it's been almost 30 minutes or so, so I can't wait to slice it and of course to eat it. And just to show you the inside texture of this luscious cake. Can you see? This is really moist and really soft for honey cake. Usually honey cake has some kind of dryness, but not this one. I need to learn to eat with smaller bites, so I'm just gonna... That's it! Okay. That's it! This is our honey cake. Fast and easy and super delicious. Visit the website for detailed recipe. And if any questions or comments, feel free to ask. I'll be happy to reply, and I hope you join me for my next video.